If you're having issues with unexplained weight gain or a difficulty losing weight, no matter what you try to do about it, diet, exercise, detoxes, whatever, then there's a strong chance that adrenal fatigue might be the underlying cause. I'm Dr. Andrew Neville, and I'm going to talk to you about how adrenal fatigue damages your metabolism and actually causes weight gain. Adrenal fatigue is terribly misunderstood, but basically what it is an overactive stress response system. Your adrenal glands produce stress hormones. One of those stress hormones is cortisol, and cortisol makes us fat. You might have seen some late-night TV ads a while ago talking about how cortisol causes belly fat. Well, that part's accurate. The products they sell for it don't work, but it's an accurate statement. And that's because the fat cells in and around the abdomen are more sensitive to cortisol, causing them to expand and actually cause weight gain. Now, the other thing that cortisol does is it increases blood sugar, and high blood sugar makes us fat. Now, there's two ways to increase the sugar in your blood. You can eat it, of course, with all the sugar and carbs that we all love, or you can get stressed. When you get stressed, your body jumps into fight or flight. It thinks you need fuel to fight that tiger that must be in front of you, and you need it immediately. So your body needs to make sugar. But if there's no tiger to run from, what does your body do with all that sugar? Well, high sugar in the blood isn't a good thing, right? So the body uses insulin to get that sugar out of the blood. Insulin escorts the sugar into the cell. It opens the door and gets that sugar out of the blood into the cell. But what if the cells don't need all that sugar? They start holding the door shut. They start becoming resistant to the insulin. So the pancreas makes more insulin to pull open the door. But if the door stays shut, insulin's got to do something with that excess sugar, so it turns it into fat and stores it for later use. Hips, thighs, belly, wherever. And we start gaining weight. So we've got excess cortisol and now excess glucose and insulin making us fat. But there's another reason that stress and adrenal fatigue make us fat. When you have stress over time, there's a metabolic exhaust in the cells from constantly being in fight or flight. And this exhaust is in the form of free radicals. Now, free radicals cause oxidative stress, which causes damage throughout the body. Part of that damage occurs within the cell in the mitochondria. These are the little energy producers in all of our cells. The job of the mitochondria is to take energy from food and turn it into a universal form of energy that we can use to do stuff. Think a thought, fight a virus, move a muscle, anything and everything. Well, when that mitochondria gets damaged, all those processes tend to grind to a halt and become less and less efficient. This results in a broken metabolism, which also makes us fat. But there's more. The last way that stress causes weight gain is that excess cortisol slows down your thyroid gland. Now, the thyroid's like the engine of your body. And when you slow down that engine of your body, everything tends to slow down. We get tired, we can't think straight, we get depressed, even constipated, and we also gain weight. You've got four things working against you. One, direct damage from cortisol. Two, increased glucose and insulin. Three, mitochondrial damage. And four, thyroid suppression. All of those things are a result of a body that's stuck in stress physiology, which is why it's so difficult to lose weight. Now, those of us who have ever carried too much weight, we know it, right? So we try to fix it. There's tons of restrictive diets or we push exercise, right? Calories in versus calories out, right? But that equation, it's too simple. There's a whole lot of metabolism that has to happen in between. And as I just explained, your metabolism is broken. Not to mention that those interventions, right, restrictive diets, excess exercise, they're stresses as well. I've had people trying to lose weight who push exercise and their weight actually goes up. The key is not to chase after the weight. Chasing the weight, which is a symptom of a bigger underlying problem, it might lead to short-term weight loss, but one misstep and that weight comes back and then some. So while I don't chase the weight issues in my practice, the weight comes off my patients over time, little by little, as we correct the broken stress physiology and the problems that I just described. Now, of course, we have to address the foods that we eat and eat in a certain way to lose weight, but adjusting the diet this way, it's actually a whole lot more simple than you've been led to believe. And I wrote a book called The Stress-Less Diet and Cookbook that explains all that. The link will be in the description. There's also certain nutritional supplements that can be used to start to fix that broken metabolism, the control insulin and the blood sugar. And I bundled several of them together just to get you started. And again, that link will be in the description. But the true long-term fix is to reverse the adrenal issues and fix that broken stress response system itself. You do all those things together, and you can watch your weight normalize over time. All my best.